Okay, so as I'm walking, I'm about to enter this random forest here in Minecraft. I can't help but be concerned about the previous video that we just did and what we're going to be looking over and talking about in this video specifically. Before we get into any more details, I have to say, if you're just stopping by for a brief 30 seconds, a minute of the video, or you're a new viewer, you're interested, you want to see more, please do scroll down, hit the like button. We're in a weird time all over the world. A lot of crazy stuff's going on, so I'm assuring that a lot of people are probably at home, a lot of people are sitting there. So one like equals one prayer that goes out to the whole world, because we need a lot of prayer right now. Especially since we're always looking at creepy stuff in regards to this game specifically as well. So one like equals one prayer. Let's get an astronomical high amount of likes. Just blow it out of the water, okay? Let's do that. Just blow it out of the water. Let's kind of do something impressive for once, right? Normally, we're like, okay, a few likes here, a few likes there. Now, let's do something a little bit different, okay? So, welcome aboard to a brand new video. If you're new here, we talk about a lot of creepy things. Not just only in Minecraft, but primarily Minecraft. And I have to tell you, some of the things we talk about scare me. Now you might be like, how in the world does a game such as this have anything scary related to it? Well, you would be surprised about the hidden secrets of entities such as Herobrine in a disc that anyone and everyone can play in Minecraft, known as Disc 11. I think after anybody hearing Disc 11, they can't help but feel maybe there is some weird undertones in this game. Maybe there is something that Mojang likes to add that creates a eerie vibe. And, well, it's a mystery that we're cracking down on each and every day to find out the oddities in this game specifically. Now, what is one thing in Minecraft that is just odd, that doesn't really make sense, that doesn't have much meaning, that does nothing but kind of scare you in its own isolated way? Well, that is, of course, no other than the Void. The place that abides under bedrock. A mystery that many people have been trying to figure out for the longest amount of time, and you might just be like, well, it's just the Void. It's just a void. There's nothing, no, what are you talking about mystery? No, there's definitely a lot more to the Void, such as people, games just crashing out of nowhere, people finding weird distorted entities that don't make or look like it belongs in Minecraft, for that matter, a skin that just is completely abnormal. Well, today we have evidence. Today we have something that just doesn't make any sense. And that is what's worrisome. That's what's kinda creating, for me personally, I don't like to go to the Void. Because sometimes it's too desolate. And on top of that, there's a vibe that comes along with it now. After some of the things that I've seen, it just creeps me out. Honestly, I prefer to go to the Nether at this point, which is saying a lot, because there's some very dark things about the Nether that we need to talk about. And if you guys want to hear me talk about that, then let me know in the comment section below. But what are we working with here today? Well, in the previous video, if you haven't seen that one, I suggest you all kind of just pause this one for the sake of it, to understand. Pause this one and go watch the previous one that we uploaded. Then, all right, we'll wait on you. Yep. Okay, I'm assuming you're back now. The previous video, we went over and we talked about how the Void just had something odd attached to it. And we even caught evidence of an odd sound that just didn't sound anything Minecraft-like. And it was very weird to witness that in the Void. And I've never witnessed a noise in the Void like that. And I think it's really odd that recently a lot of people are coming forth in just kind of speaking upon some of the weird things they have found in the Void. And me personally, I find this very scary. I'm very concerned that more people are hearing things and seeing things of relating sort. Now, wow, there are zombies burning in the broad daylight here. Is this a zombie? Oh my god, it is. A village that has been completely overrun with zombies, and its infection just grows to nearby villages till they're all consumed into one zombie-like state. It's kind of horrifying considering the recent events of the world. Anyways, so yeah. We're going to show a clip of footage that I had from way back. I don't even remember how long ago this was, but it was forever ago. We're going to show footage of this clip, an entity that, well, disappeared in a blink of an eye that just looks so wrong and distorted, and it didn't make much sense at all. It's very terrifying. I don't know if I'm going to include the audio of when I found this, but you will notice my reaction. I'm very surprised, I'm very on edge, and I don't quite know what the heck is going on. But without further ado, check out that clip.
What is that? It's glitching. Do you guys see that? Guys, look at this. Look at it. It's like glitching. It looks like it. Oh my God. What's that? Why did it turn black? Do you guys see that? A black speck just showed up on this character. Oh. Oh, wow. I don't like this, guys. I should have known better to return to this world. I should have known better. Did you guys see that, though? A black, like, substance or something. What? Where'd he go? Oh. Wait, what's going on? He's like disappearing and reappearing. There he goes again. Oh my God, did you see that? He was like over there for a second.
Okay, I'm assuming you're back after seeing that, and you're probably like, what in the world? I have never seen nothing like that. I've never seen an entity like that. Well, that's what I said. And I was very, very much so surprised to find and see something like that myself. And I wasn't the only person to have sighted this. Other people have as well. When I found that entity, multiple people said they were in the void and they seen glimpses of an entity just exactly like that one off in the distance as they were in the void. So, I hate to tell you this all right now after showing you something so terrifying like that, but we are now going back down into the void. I'm not even kidding you, the second I started going down, I'm getting chills already. Like, I'm already getting chills again in this void. Oh, God. I hate how the world just generates and makes this creepy. I don't like it. Alright, anyways, maybe I'm overreacting, maybe I'm not. So anyways, this is the floor ground of the void. The area that you can walk in, obviously you can only do this in creative, by the way. If you're in survival, you're going to die instantly. The void has a way of suffocating you and pretty much just depleting you of all your energy. It's very, very sad thing. But, basically, we can walk around here. I think that's from like a previous yesterday. But we can walk around here, and we're at the floor level. Now, this is where I spotted this thing. Now, the crazy thing about the void is it's kind of like fog. You cannot see what's in front of you till you get like right there. Because even with the high render distance, you can tell that the blocks are rendered out extremely far from me. However, when I came across this entity, I walked right up on him. It's very weird, and like if you stay a certain distance, then he'll just disappear, which I think is just the weird render distance and fog-like ability that the void kind of gives it. And this is creepy, because I've been in the void way before I knew all this creepy stuff was originating, and I've literally lost my friends in the void. Like, we both goofing around in the void, gone. We can't find each other, we're freaking out. We can't even find the exit where we first, came down into the void, and I'm telling you, it was a creepy in its own way. And now knowing that something dark and mysterious and just creatures, I don't know what you call that entity, a creature, a distorted being, a glitch, and the weird noise that we heard in the previous one, I just, something doesn't seem right. You get what I'm saying? So let's get out of here before I get creeped out too much. Say what you are. So I'm gonna go ahead and zoom out of here, see if we can get a little bit of the daytime, nighttime sky, sun setting type of vibrant essence going on here. Yeah, maybe I'm going through another thing. Look at this, the sunset. That kind of sets the tone slightly better for us. What the heck was that? Oh, I can't stand that. Oh, no. Oh, Jesus. Okay. I'm terribly sorry. I landed on the tree, right? And I heard the bee right in my ear. Now, okay, this is the thing. I don't know if any of you have just been sitting somewhere and there's like a fly or some bug of sort that gets right in your ear and you can just hear it. Oh, that's what that sounded like. And it just, I thought I, like, for a second, okay, for a brief moment, I forgot that Minecraft had bees. And I heard this buzzing noise in my ear, and I thought there was a bug in my ear. And I cannot stand that. I don't like that. Okay. I don't know how there would be a bug in my ear when I have headphones on, but you know what? I thought there was for a second. Give me a break, okay? Oh my god, that is not cool. All right. Well, anyways, we're talking about the void here. I got distracted horribly. I don't know. Is that only happened to me? Probably. All right. We're going back to our campfire here, and you know, we're gonna have to bring back the campfire tales or something, right? We might have to. Anyways, if you all enjoyed today's video, hit the like button, subscribe, enable post notification, ring the bell, make it go ding. It's gonna pretty much notify you every single upload. Share with friends, family, everyone you know. It's a journey. It really is a journey. And we are continuing the journey. Furthermore, I think it's gonna be interesting. It's really gonna be interesting. So, yeah, with that aside, don't get scared of the void too much. Be careful on your investigations alongside me, because I've seen comments of people finding things that they wish they never found. So be careful out there. And don't search for the wrong. At least you beware. All